So here's how to use a VPN. It's actually very simple and it should be somewhat automatic once you have it installed. So I've installed a VPN here. I'm using one called Cloak and it's at getcloak.com. Now this isn't necessarily one that I've determined is the best. I've tried a few. This one works really well, so I've stuck with it. And this plan that I'm using applies to all my Macs and my iOS devices as well. So I'm able to just have one plan and then use it through all of them. And what I get once I've installed Cloak, I've downloaded and installed it, is at the top here, I've got this little icon here that gives me access to Cloak. So right now I'm connected to Wi-Fi, and you can see I'm using a trusted network. So my own home network, I've indicated to Cloak in the preferences that it's trusted and there's no need to use VPN. But as soon as I connect to another Wi-Fi connection, like say one at a hotel or a coffee shop or something like that, then automatically it's going to try to secure my connection. Now I can manually try to secure it right here by clicking the Secure My Connection button to override my preference not to use it there. But I can also go in and change how things work. So right now, for instance, under networks, I've got several networks here that I've listed as being totally okay. I have various other things. Like for instance, I can say I want to connect to a VPN only in the United States. It has all these different VPNs, so they have different servers all around the world, and the default will be to set to fastest available. The downside to using fastest available is sometimes the fastest one may be outside of the country, especially if you're traveling. So what happens then is your IP address that servers think that you have, and then when they try to locate you, seems to be from somewhere else. So for instance, if I was hooked up to Japan, I would automatically get the Japanese version of some websites because it determines that I'm in Japan. But if I stick with the United States, that means my connection is going to go from Japan all the way back to the United States and it will appear as if I'm in the US. It's kind of a nice thing there because then I get the English language version of websites. It doesn't confuse the site by making them think I'm in Japan or somewhere else. So it's kind of a nice benefit. If I was not using VPN, that would be automatic. If I'm connecting from Japan, it would think I'm in Japan, which I am, and I may get the wrong language on a website. I've got my account information, I've got updates, there's some advanced settings and things like that. But in general, once you have it set up, and if your network is not listed here, then you can count on the fact that it will connect automatically. So you don't have to do anything. You just simply connect to the Wi-Fi at a coffee shop. It will then automatically start connecting here. You'll see some dots, and then it'll come up with a check mark that it's connected. So let's try securing my connection here now. And you can see it attempting to do it, and I don't even have to have that open. You can see that it changed there. And now I've got this blue icon here, and it tells me by a notification that my connection is secured. So now I'm actually using a VPN, just like I showed in yesterday's video. My connection is secured between myself and Cloak, and then Cloak then goes out to the internet. So my ISP, the Wi-Fi router, or anything, any other steps there, they're not going to know where I'm going or what information I'm sending. It's secret information between me and the VPN server, in this case Cloak. And of course I'm trusting Cloak because I'm paying them and I've looked into them and I've decided that I will trust them, although not necessarily trust the ISP that say is at the coffee shop or at the hotel. And that's the idea behind VPN. It's really easy to install any of these VPNs. They all kind of install and run automatically. Most of them have trials, so you can just search for Mac VPN and come up with different plans, different prices, different features. I like how this little interface works here, so it's another plus for me for Cloak, but some may actually have a better interface. So you may want to just give some a try. If you've tried a VPN and you like it, please leave a mention in the comments, because it'd be nice for other people to see which other VPNs people recommend.